Coming up on this edition of the FGCU Sports Report, a newly sanctioned NCAA sport hits the sand courts at Florida Gulf Coast. We serve up the questions to a pair of Eagle tennis standouts and Director of Corporate Sales and Marketing Denise Dasilvetta and volleyball coach Dave Nichols stop by to chat in the interview corral. All that and more on this edition of the FGCU Sports Report.
The FGCU Sports Report is made possible by Mutual of Omaha Bank, matching the right financial service to the right customer at the right time. Mutual of Omaha Bank, your bank every step of the way. And by the Joint Academy at Lehigh Regional Medical Center, specializing in total joint replacement surgery, dedicated to your good health always. Want more from your bank? We'll give you advice you can rely on, security you can trust. Personal or professional, whichever you like. Bankers here invest time with you to secure your financial future. Family investments, business credit, wealth management. More than a bank, we are family at Mutual of Omaha Bank. Your bank, every step of the way. Offices Naples, Marco Island, Fort Myers, Tampa.
Do you need knee, hip, or shoulder replacement? Visit the Joint Academy at Lehigh Regional Medical Center, specializing in total joint replacement surgery. The doctors and staff will assist you in all aspects of your care, from preparing for surgery to your return to normal activities as soon as possible.
It's good professional staff. They just do their job very well, and I recommend it highly.
The Joint Academy at Lehigh Regional Medical Center, dedicated to your good health always.
Hello, Eagles fans. I'm your host, Tom James, and welcome to this edition of the FGCU Sports Report. Southwest Florida is world-renowned for its abundant sunshine, outdoor activities, and beautiful white beaches. So when FGCU added a new sport to this year's schedule, it only made sense to take advantage of our natural resources. Sports reporter Rod Clark checked out the action as the indoor volleyball team learned how to adapt to the sand in this brand new NCAA sport.
One, two.
We do most of our training here on campus, and they work hard. We push the sled out there. They do sprints in here holding on harnesses. We work with medicine balls out here. We do shuffle work. So we use these two sand courts extensively.
Beach volleyball has been around in one form or another since the early 1920s. It became an Olympic sport in 1996, but the NCAA, which calls it sand volleyball, only recently granted it official status. And this year, the Eagles are fielding their first ever team. And all that training seems to have paid off. The fledgling Eagles took to the home sand at Estero Community Park for the first time ever on March 30th, handing the visiting Stetson squad a 3-2 defeat. Combined with their win over Stetson a week earlier, that also marked the team's first ever set of back-to-back victories.
It's what's called an emerging sport. We're given a 10-year window to increase up to 40 teams. When you get 40 teams who will sponsor it, it becomes an official championship. There are 16 teams currently this season, 5 in the Atlantic Sun Conference. There is going to be a national championship, but it's not going to count yet. It'll be an exhibition national championship until they hit the 40 teams.
Team members are aware that being on the first FGCU beach volleyball team, the school's 15th sport, bestows pioneer status on them.
A little bit of a pioneer, I guess, but it's just a great experience. You know, a whole new game is coming here, and it's just going to be phenomenal because other big schools have picked it up already, and so we're just becoming one of those big schools, and this is just proof of it.
The fledgling FGCU beach volleyball team is made up mostly of members of the indoor team, but that likely will change as the sport evolves.
Indoor is a very specialized game. You have hitters, you have small defenders. The beach, you have to be well-rounded. So over time, I think we'll have a different type of player.
We're just missing two girls from the indoor team out here. So as of right now, the indoor girls are all basically playing beach. But as beach volleyball becomes more prominent, then they'll just recruit girls that only play beach volleyball.
They may look similar to the uninitiated, but beach and indoor volleyball are vastly different sports. different rules, different skills, different training, different coaching techniques, even a different ball. And on sand, a team fields just two players at a time, not six.
Yes, it's quite different. There's rules determining what's legal on the first contact. In indoor, you can send a third ball over with an open hand. On the sand, you have to keep it closed. So there are some different rules, and most of my girls are pure indoor players, so they're like, what, huh? But you know, we'll get that.
Indoor is such a totally different game than this is. Indoor, you have to be so quick and agile, and you make little movements, but out here on the beach, you have to know everything about the game. You don't just play one position, you play both positions, since there's only two of you. So it's a completely different game. So yeah, adapting from indoor to this is just incredible.
It's a lot more physically demanding. Although indoor is demanding too, beach is really tough. You have to be able to move quickly, and the sand wants to hold you down. So you have to move fast, and you have to give it all you've got, and it really makes you a lot stronger.
And there is the weather to consider.
It really affects you depending on what side you are. Like if the wind is in your face, you know that you can just rip the ball. When you're serving, when you're hitting, you can hit so much harder.
The girls are all really close. We have a really good bond. We're always doing everything together.
And I think the girls don't feel the same pressure that you feel with indoor, and don't feel the same kind of sense of urgency. It will develop and become more kind of dog-eat-dog, but right now it's a fairly fun environment.
Thanks, Rod. And to find out more about sand volleyball, as well as scores and highlights for all of FGCU sports, log on to the FGCUathletics.com website, the official site of the FGCU Eagles. Here's Dave Nichols, head volleyball coach at FGCU. Great having you back on the show.
Good to see you, Tom.
You're a busy guy of late. Volleyball in the fall, sand volleyball in the spring, plus recruiting.
Yeah, and the sand schedule is really compacted. They had to get it all done in March and April, so we essentially had seven straight weekends of competition, and I should have been at several junior club tournaments actually, you know, feeding the indoor program, but luckily I've got a great assistant who is taking care of that.
Well, FGCU just added sand volleyball. How did that come about?
I believe that they had to add some kind of sport. There's been a lot of interest in it, and it's one that you can run for probably a little bit less than some other sports there. You don't need, you know, to build a stadium or to do these types of things. So I said, okay, let's see if we can get it up and running. And we were basically indoor girls faking the sand game this year, but had a lot of fun, and it makes them better volleyball players.
And describe it to us, if you will, two-on-two, much like beach volleyball that you see in the Olympics, for example.
Absolutely, which was the first ticket to sell out for the 2012 games, by the way. It's pretty popular. What it is, it's based a little bit on the dual meet format of tennis. We have five pairs. We have to rank them 1 through 5. You can't mess around and, you know, send your best team down to 5 to try and beat people. Not that we would ever think like that. So it's the best 3 out of 5. You play 2 out of 3 games to 21. The third game is to 15 if necessary. You have to have at least 3 courts in order to run it properly.
And you're just getting started with this at FGCU, and some of your regular volleyball players are not so accustomed yet to sand volleyball.
True, and you could see that. We got a lot better. The opening match we had 3 practices, and we looked awful, you know, as we went into that. And it's frustrating because they're good volleyball players, but playing indoor and outdoor are completely different animals. But they worked really hard. We got a lot of practices in, and by the end of the season, they were fairly credible. And the good thing is there's a huge carryover to the indoor game. So if you get skilled on the sand, it's only going to make you better. You jump higher, you get really fit. It ain't easy working on that stuff. And it gives you a much better way of reading the game. Plus, you're responsible for every contact. So it's a great game for them. But, yes, we went through a learning curve for sure.
Well, and I was going to ask you that, would sand volleyball help the games of these girls once the regular season came around? And physically, more than anything else?
Physically, mentally, and in terms of skill. There's a great history of indoor players, best in the world, who play sand volleyball as well. you know, Karch Karai was our greatest sand player and considered the best indoor player of all time. I think the carryover is huge. Our Olympic teams that won gold in the 80s, even the middle blockers were good beach players. So there's a huge carryover. Right now there's a woman called Logan Tom. She's considered the best outside hitter in the world. She had been all indoor, and she was good, average. Mm-hmm. I mean, good. But she went and played pro beach for 2 years, and when she returned from pro beach and went back to the indoor game, she's now considered the number one outside hitter in the world. So I think there's a huge carryover for it, even though the girls got frustrated at times, like, this is hard.
Takes some time.
but they got better and better.
Back to the main volleyball schedule, big improvement for you guys this year, 18-13 overall, 10-3 in the A-Sun, finishing third in the league this year.
Yeah, one game. We were up 2-0 against Stetson and let one get away. Otherwise, it's a three-way tie for first place because the two teams that tied were 11-2. So we're very close, and that's starting four freshmen. You know, we like where we're going in this. And also, you have to realize in our scheduling of those 13 losses, we're playing Penn State, we're playing USC, we're playing some of the top programs in the country. Mm-hmm. I'm not trying to, you know, get 20 wins by playing Sisters of the Poor. So, you know, we're really trying to improve our visibility and show the girls this is the level you got to get to.
Now, aside from exemplary coaching, obviously, why
of course.
Why the improvement this year?
Healthy. We had 5 surgeries the year before. We were playing walk-ons in starting positions, and they played great for us, but they weren't supposed to be in starters. So we were healthy. We felt we had a great recruiting year. You know, there's a lot of young talent that is maturing and getting better all the time. So a combination of factors. Yeah.
You see a big carryover for next year?
Huge carryover. This team is hungry. They're motivated. And, you know, hey, when soccer's winning the conference title and getting a shot at the NCAAs in basketball, yeah, there's some motivation, which is great. There's this wonderful kind of rivalry. Well, if you guys are going to do that, we're going to go one further. Heck, we're going to get to the tournament and win a game.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so there's this feeling going through all the sports right now, and it's just an awesome way. That's how a department should be.
All right. Great having you here, as always.
Absolutely,
Dave
Tom.
Nichols,
good
thank
to see
you.
You.
And if you're a fan of the social media, you can always like the Sports Report on Facebook and tweet us on Twitter. And you can watch your favorite episodes of the Sports Report 24/7 on YouTube. Just log on to the addresses on the screen and enjoy.
Do you need knee, hip, or shoulder replacement? Visit the Joint Academy at Lehigh Regional Medical Center, specializing in total joint replacement surgery. The doctors and staff will assist you in all aspects of your care, from preparing for surgery to your return to normal activities as soon as possible.
It's good professional staff. They just do their job very well, and I recommend it highly.
The Joint Academy at Lehigh Regional Medical Center, dedicated to your good health, always.
Want more from your bank? We'll give you advice you can rely on, security you can trust. Personal or professional, whichever you like. Bankers here invest time with you to secure your financial future. Family investments, business credit, wealth management. More than a bank, we are family at Mutual of Omaha Bank. Your bank, every step of the way. Offices Naples, Marco Island, Fort Myers, Tampa.
Being a tennis guy, it's great to have a couple of tennis players in the studio with us today. Sarah Means and Matt Rock from the FGCU tennis team. It's great having you stop by. Thank you, guys.
Thank you for having us.
Sarah, I'll start with you. You're coming off your freshman season. Give us a little recap. How was it?
It was a great season. I mean, I just want to get better from here, but I'm happy about how the season went.
What brought you to FGCU?
Well, I knew the assistant coach previously, and I knew that Coach Gabu had a lot of great experience considering her tremendous high college career. So I was attracted to the school because of that, and it was close to home.
And Matt, you just completed your senior season and headed towards graduation now. You're on the other end of the spectrum. What's the journey been like for you all the way through?
It's been crazy. I mean, it's been a long trip from year to year, and then this year really was a big turnaround. It's really great to see that. And then making it to conference was huge. Is one of my goals the past few years. So.
And I know you have the Mohawk now, and all, the whole team did that for for the conference tournament?
After we beat Belmont, we went there like, we got to do something for conference. So all got Mohawks either willingly or forcefully. So.
Okay, but everybody did it as a one unit.
Yeah.
Sarah, I know tennis runs in your family, and you and your sister Elizabeth in high school won the state doubles title in 3A. How did you get started in tennis all the way back?
Well, someone told my mother after observing me that I had good eye-hand coordination, so they just suggested that I pick up the game, and I've been playing ever since.
And Matt, take me all the way back with you. What got you cranked up in the sport of tennis?
My family. I have five brothers and sisters, two older and three younger, and my dad and mom played years and years back, and I grew up with the sport since I ever remember. I just remember always being on the courts.
Yeah. Now, some words of wisdom, I guess, because since you are the veteran, you've been all the way through, and Sarah's just completing her freshman year as she goes forward here at FGCU. Any advice for her to enjoy the whole road?
I just say keep trying to have fun during the time. It's going to go by very fast.
Yeah.
I remember I just started yesterday. Pretty much all, yeah.
Yeah. What are some of the things that you learned that maybe how you're different now than you were when you first started in college tennis?
I'd say I'm a lot more patient at times, a lot more mentally stable. Like I would just lose my mind like my freshman year and stuff like that. Little things would just get at me, and now I think I'm a lot more mentally tough on the court, I'd say.
Yeah. And as you move forward, what are some of your goals for your sophomore year and on down the road in tennis?
I definitely want to improve strategically so that I'm able to understand my opponent better and use that to my advantage.
And since graduation is on the horizon for you, what about after FGCU? What's going on for you after college?
I'm still on that track of figuring that out myself.
Okay.
I'm thinking about just doing this, taking the summer just to think about that. I've usually just doing summer jobs, something like that, just teaching tennis and stuff like that.
Okay.
So I think I'm gonna take that time and do that, get a little bit of cash, and maybe do some just some tournaments, stuff like that, just to keep myself into tennis. But I might have other opportunities that I'm thinking maybe grad schools in the future. I'm not really sure yet.
Gotcha. Well, we wish you both the best of luck, and thanks for joining us on the show.
Thank you.
Thank you.
And to find out more about Eagles tennis and all of FGCU sports, go to FGCUathletics.com, the official site of the FGCU Eagles. Denise Dasilveta, Director of Corporate Sales and Marketing on the FGCU Sports Report with us today. Thanks for coming in.
So happy to be here. Thank you for having me.
All right. First of all, tell us a little bit about the different facets of your job.
Well, as the Director of both sponsorships in the community and marketing, what we try to do is create what I like to refer to as the three-legged stool with the community, the university, and the students. I count the students somewhat separately because they're such an integral part of what we do at FGCU. And we've worked really hard with FGCU student community to give them a sense of place in Alico Arena at Swanson Stadium, at the soccer stadium, et cetera. It's been really, really a big part of what we've done over the last 3 years. And it's been a lot of fun.
You're very visible at FGCU basketball games, baseball games, all the sports events. And a lot of the things that the fans see and are a part of run directly through you.
It's such an invigorating and passionate job. Many days I have the luckiest job in the universe. A couple of days of the year, not so much. It can get a little stressful putting on as many events as we do. But what's really fun about it is to see, as we've added more game day atmosphere to basketball in particular, and also soccer, baseball, volleyball, softball, etc., as we've had more sponsors have special events at halftime and media timeouts and between innings.
Yeah.
The engagement from the fans has increased and our attendance has increased. And so we just really look to talk to the community and engage them to become part of FGCU so that the fans feel a sense of community when they're in the arena or in our facilities.
I've noticed doing play-by-play on all the games that the student attendance, the student crowds keep getting bigger and bigger, and I know that's something that makes you smile.
Well, very, very much so. When I was interviewed, one of the things that was very clear during the interview process is the coaches felt like we had a long way to go with student attendance in particular and with attendance overall. We don't have competition in the area as far as other D1 programs. We don't have professional teams that we're competing against per se. We have some good friends in minor league with the Everblades and with the Miracle, but those are friendly and wonderful relationships. And so we would really like for sports enthusiasts to frequent FGCU. And so what we've tried to do is develop a communications model that lets them know about our events, let them know about special incentives and promotions that we do so that they come out and try us, because we've been so successful. We've had an easy time keeping people and bringing them back.
What are some of the things that you do to get some of the on-campus groups involved in the different events?
Well, I like to refer to FGCU students that are involved as Alpha Eagles.
Okay.
The Alpha Eagle concept is something we talk about when we strategize, because like any community, you've kind of got the 80-20 rule. 20% of the people are involved at a very high level and 80% somewhat. But if you can get the 20% that have a propensity to engage, to know about you, then things will naturally build from there. And so what we've tried to do is engage the leadership on campus through student government, through programming board, through clubs that are called RSOs at FGCU, and through the Greek organizations, through speaking to that leadership and having incentives. We have a Spirit Cup. The Eagle Spirit Cup is an award we give out during each sporting season. And with those special programs, students have just really responded.
Right.
Then we've had very generous sponsors like Self-Insured Plans, SIP, that sponsors Best of the Nest at halftime for basketball,
right,
which has been very popular with the students. And they've given away Apple iPads and do what's called Diamond Dollars for baseball and softball for hitting the SIP sign. You can win the pot. Students can. And so a lot of our attendance initiatives have been directed at students. But what's awesome is our season ticket holders and adult fans have also come out in bigger numbers because they've enjoyed the energy and the positive momentum.
And the energy and the growth has been terrific. Denise, thanks for joining us today.
Very much my pleasure.
All right. And as always, you can find the Sports Report on both Facebook and Twitter, and catch your favorite past episodes of the Sports Report on YouTube. Just log on to the addresses on the screen and enjoy.
Want more from your bank? We'll give you advice you can rely on, security you can trust. Personal or professional, whichever you like. Bankers here invest time with you to secure your financial future. Family investments, business credit, wealth management. More than a bank, we are family at Mutual of Omaha Bank. Your bank, every step of the way. Offices Naples, Marco Island, Fort Myers, Tampa.
Do you need knee, hip, or shoulder replacement? Visit the Joint Academy at Lehigh Regional Medical Center, specializing in total joint replacement surgery. The doctors and staff will assist you in all aspects of your care, from preparing for surgery to your return to normal activities as soon as possible.
It's good professional staff. They just do their job very well, and I recommend it highly.
The Joint Academy at Lehigh Regional Medical Center, dedicated to your good health, always.
Well, the buzzer has sounded for today's show, but never fear, we'll be back again next month with another edition of the FGCU Sports Report. I'm Tom James. Thanks for watching, and go Eagles!